Epidemic Sound's team has been working hard on improving the platform for us users, and this year they've released some new AI tools that, don't worry, are not about some weird AI-generated music or something like that. The tools are designed to speed up the process for us editors and make the whole soundtracking part of the editing process smoother. So in this video, I'm going to show you how the Assistant tool and the Adapt tool work and how I use them in my workflow. Let's begin. Here in my editor, I have a little project laid out. These are some of my favorite clips from a 50-minute long video that I made about a trip across Germany. And now I want to make a 30-second version, sort of a teaser, for social media and elevate the sound design a little. The timeline is currently a little too long, but that is okay because I want to find the music first and then edit the final cut with the music. So to find music, let's head over to the AI assistant. I've become very fond of using this to kickstart my music searching process. Basically, this is exactly what it sounds like. It's a virtual assistant. So instead of spending hours scrolling through the music catalog trying to find the right track that suits your needs, you can describe what you're looking for and let the assistant find it for you. Let's go ahead and talk to it. For this video, I simply wrote out what I'm looking for. I literally just asked it if it had something that fits my description. In this case, I was looking for something melancholic because I wanted to make the video sound nostalgic, like something I want to look back on from the past that cannot come back. Usually, the first response is a decent suggestion with minor differences to what I'm seeking that I can then point out and correct. So here, I clicked the Find Similar button to reference the track in my next message, and told the assistant that this one is the closest to what I'm looking for, and pointed out what I liked. So I said that I enjoyed the dark, bass-heavy sound of this track and that the other suggestions were too bright. Also, I mentioned that the piano is not the right instrument in this case and the more electronic-sounding guitar tracks work better. And with that extra feedback, the assistant gave me a few better, more specific suggestions. In this case, I asked once more to focus even more on the dark ambient genre, and that is how I came across Snowblind by Ave Air, which suited my video idea. Then, as mentioned, this is a short 30-second clip for social media, so it would be great to have a shorter version of the track, which you can get directly in Epidemic Sound with the Adapt feature. This tool lets you make changes to the length or even to the tone. I ended up making a 37-second version, which sounded the best, and then added that to my timeline. The next step was to edit the video to fit the song's length, so I cut down the timeline only to keep my favorite shots and ended up with a 35-second long video with music and the original sound. Now, before adding sound effects, there was one more important step to do before, which is to adjust the existing sound. So I went through the timeline one by one and adjusted the levels of the sound depending on whether I want to keep it, highlight it, or push it in the background to make space for other sounds. So now the stage was set to add my sound effects. To find the sounds I'm looking for, I went to Epidemic Sound's assistant feature again and described the shot and sounds I needed. So yes, this tool works with the entire library, not just the music, but also sound effects. And I like to literally talk to the assistant like with a human assistant and describe the shot and the sounds I'm looking for, and I like to be rather descriptive here because I want to give it as much information as possible so that I get the optimal results. In this case, I asked it for the sound of a car, wind, and some rustling leaves. The assistant gave me a choice of sounds for each request I had. Here, I used the reference function again to reference a specific sound from the assistant's selection, which was the closest to what I was looking for. I then refined my description as I realized that I needed something slightly deeper sounding. After downloading the audio clips I liked, I layered them below the original sound of my video clip. From here on, I basically went back and forth doing the same process again and again anytime I needed some new sounds. Of course, some sounds could just be reused or I was able to use different bits of the same file. And every time I needed something new, I simply told the assistant what I'm looking for and it gave me a selection based on my description. This has been a great time saver for me in my workflow because when I can describe in more detail what I'm looking for rather than simply using a keyword or two, I can skip the process of clicking through countless effects that are in the same category but don't suit my needs. I've been especially fond of using this for my music search because when I work on my videos, that has always been a part of the process that took quite a long time. Anyway, after a couple minutes, I had added all the extra sound effects I wanted to add to create a more immersive experience for the viewer. Finally, I did some slight adjusting to the volume and the overall mix so that I don't overload the sound design with too many sounds, because that is totally a thing that can happen and affect the video negatively. I'm trying to strike a balance here. And then I was done. Here is the final result. So that wraps up this tutorial. Epidemic Sound has been working hard on giving us these new features such as Assistant and Adapt, which enable a faster, more efficient workflow for us editors. I recommend giving these a try. I hope this video could show you an example of what that can look like. That's all for today. Thank you to Epidemic Sound for having me, and I shall see you again some other time. Until then, goodbye.